Hey, hey, I'm Kim Day. Welcome to the channel and to today's video. It's a pleasure to have you. I hope you're doing all right today. I am looking forward to this review. We're gonna be breaking down the difference between the two ILIA foundations. On one hand, we have the Super Serum Skin Tint, and on the other, we have the True Skin Serum Foundation. I definitely have seen a lot of this going around on the internet, and I have a feeling that people are gonna wanna be picking it up more for summertime because of the claims and because of all of the little videos you see of people using it and it looking so fresh and it's got SPF in it. But I want to shed some light on this one as well and help you make the best decision as far as which one to choose and what's gonna work best for you. I'm next to a window right now, so if you see a little bit of light leakage, it's okay. We're just hanging out with the sun. For background, I've had these for, I wanna say almost 6 months. Yeah, probably about 6 months. And I've had a good chance and a good opportunity to try and test out the best ways that I like to apply this, what I like to wear it with, and what works best for me and my skin. So I hope I can give you a quick little demo and review that will help you again in your decision making. First, I just want to let you know about my skin type. Now, we're kind of coming into the warmer summer months, and I know that my skin's going to adjust. It's so funny because I just started figuring out my routines both for skincare and makeup, and now I know that it's going to be warmer and I'm going to be sweating, so we're starting from scratch basically. But generally speaking, I have pretty typical combo skin. I get pretty oily around my T-zone, and then I get dry in certain areas, especially if I'm dealing with breakouts and I'm doing anything to treat them, I'll deal with some dry patches. I do have some acne scarring on both of my cheeks, kind of more on my cheek up here and more around my chin over here. So you'll also be able to see the kind of coverage that both of these will give, and I'll talk more about each of them once we get started. I'm gonna do one on each side and we'll do a comparison. So for starters, I'm gonna do the Super Serum Skin Tint on the left side of my face. Let's go. I recommend giving it a good shake just because it's super packed with a lot of ingredients, a lot of skincare ingredients. So I want you to think of this seriously like it is a mixture of your serums that you might have at home, including niacinamide, squalane, and hyaluronic acid, and which is funny because those are all things that I have in my cabinet right now, and a skin tint. And on top of that, it's got SPF. So if you don't think that this is a thick formula, you are in for a treat. It is very, I think the word is viscous, which is funny because that's a word, oh, I'm spilling. I'm trying to make it cool for you guys, but I'm spilling, so I'm not gonna waste any more product, sorry. I laugh when I say the word viscous because I feel like if you've ever tried to type the word vicious and weren't sure how to spell it, you might have accidentally spelled it as viscous. So there's that. What I'm gonna do is actually take a little bit of micellar water and remove it from this part of my face because what I've learned is that it works best with as minimal skincare as possible. Now that leads me to my basically only, okay, my number one claim for this or thing to keep an eye out for is that yes, it has SPF in it, but I don't think it's meant to replace a full coverage, full broad spectrum sunscreen. So if you really do feel like wearing this like out and about, out in the sun, I think you should wear it with a sunscreen under and then do this on top. But if you're, you know, just kind of going in and out, or if you're staying inside primarily, or if you're just not gonna be like roasting in the sun, this is great with an SPF 40 coverage. So let's get into it. Like I said, it's very viscous. It's thick. She's a thick girl. And I've noticed that I just like to apply it with my hands, which is interesting because I'm usually a tool girl. I like brushes, I like sponges, but this works best with my hands. Because it has all of those skincare ingredients, I've noticed that it just kind of gets, those get soaked up into my sponges and into my brushes especially, and I just don't get as much on my face as I wish I would. So using my fingers helps me kind of press and wipe it into my skin. I don't rub too aggressively because I do want to be mindful of the tint that's there. Yes, I want to get the skincare on my skin, but I don't want to rub away the color and the coverage. So I just do really light kind of back and forth strokes, some pats to kind of blend in any streaks, and then I just leave it at that. So yeah, you have to clean up your fingers. Not my favorite part, but I do think it's the best way to get a nice even layer of coverage. Now I will say when I first tried this, I was blown away by the actual coverage, and I did think for whatever reason that it was a lot more liquidy, but because it's so thick and rich, and because it's a tinted sunscreen, it shows up a little bit lighter. When you saw me first put it on, you're probably like, what is this girl doing? That is not her color. But once you rub it in, it settles and kind of adjusts and sets down to the color that it's meant to be. I'm using the shade Diaz, if that helps you at all. I have a pretty light, medium, neutral skin tone, generally speaking. And I think it's pretty great. I will say, if you are an oily person, even if you're combo like me, one, give yourself a good at least 10 minutes for this to set so you can really see what the finish is gonna be on you. Because when you first put it on, it might feel and or look a little bit heavy and sticky, which I'm already not necessarily looking forward to for the summertime, just because I know that I'm gonna get wet and sticky on my own. And it doesn't always have the lightest feel, especially if you maybe layer a little bit, because I think it is slightly layerable if you want more coverage out of it. But the less you use, the lighter it will feel, especially on drier skin. But give yourself a good 10, if you can, go up to like 30 minutes. Let it really sink in, and then you can kind of figure out if this is something that you want to use for the day or if you need to use a powder, things like that. I say this because that was definitely something that I needed to remind myself of, because when I first put it on, it's very dewy, very shiny, almost too much so, especially if you put it like all around. If I put it under my lip, I have a shiny upper lip, and that's not really what I'm looking for. But if you let it sit for a little bit and put powder on just sparingly where you need to, I think you're still gonna really like the coverage. It won't feel too heavy. It's not great under a mask if you don't set properly with a powder or a setting spray. So again, just things to keep in mind, and it's all about adjusting to what makes sense for you. On the other side, we're gonna try out the True Skin Serum Foundation. It's lightweight, smoothing, and aloe infused. I have this in the shade Selena, which is, I would say, a little bit darker and a little warmer than Diaz, which I think is gonna suit me a little bit better for summer, but just a heads up, they're not the exact same shade comparison, but I think it's gonna work pretty nicely still. So I apply this like I do my regular foundations, and that is usually with a brush. I have used a sponge before. It doesn't really make that big of a difference, but I like using a fluffy, sort of medium dense brush, just because I can almost kind of airbrush it across my face. And because it's a lighter, thinner formula, definitely not like my full coverage foundations, I almost prefer it, because this is something that I like to use when I want that lighter coverage that doesn't feel heavy, that doesn't cling to my dry spots, etc, etc. Basically, I go for both of my ILIA products when my skin is behaving a little bit better. And then I just go in and spot treat as I need. So I just build coverage in different areas where I want it. And there we have it. It's a nice light, medium coverage. Buildable, yes, but I think the max you can get out of it is a very like natural medium finish. This is definitely lighter in texture and also in coverage when you first apply it. Again, it's just not that thick, heavy texture. It feels much more like a regular foundation. It actually kind of smells like one too. But what I will say is that it is a little bit drier. So for my oily people, I would actually probably recommend this a little bit more for you, just because it's gonna feel easier and you're not gonna need that dry down time to really assess if it makes sense for you or not. I actually sometimes, when I'm feeling a little bit drier, notice that I need to exfoliate a little bit better. And when it comes to like right before makeup, I actually just use micellar water and a cotton round. That usually does a good job gently of getting those dead dry patches away, and then kind of amping up my moisturizer, because it is a little bit more dry. I wouldn't say it's matte necessarily, because if I were to be in the sun, I'll still have a nice glow, especially if you prep really well with your skincare underneath, but it's definitely more of a natural finish, which I can appreciate. Really quickly, I'm gonna add a couple finishing touches, you know, like some concealer, some blush, you know, the works, just so that I feel a little bit more awake and alive. And I'll get back to you in just a few seconds with my full comparison and final review. Hey again, I'm back, but I wanna get in a little bit closer, just cause I know you can't really see a lot of detail around the coverage. So I'm hoping this might help at least a little bit better. So on this side, this is the Super Serum Skin Tint side. I had some acne scarring here that is still visible, but it's definitely muted. It's definitely evened out my skin tone a lot more because I deal with some redness around my nose. Now, this is something I recommend using a concealer with still. I used concealer under here and under my eyes just because I prefer the coverage of the two together. I don't think I get the full amount of coverage that I want when it comes to really getting those dark or red spots, but this is again a nice light medium coverage. And then on the other side, this is the True Skin Serum Foundation. Again, I would almost say similar coverage, but still some light visible redness. But I don't really mind it because when I use, I zoomed the wrong way. When I use ILIA specifically, I don't know if it's just a psychological thing, but I like to use it when I want a really light and fresh finish on my makeup and on my face. So basically the whole like my skin but better type look. You know, those natural clean beauty brands that's really there to get like a skin-like finish, still look like you. These are definitely things that I kind of interchange and go to on a regular basis, knowing that I'm gonna still be able to see some of my little freckles, things like that, and I'll still feel like myself, just a little bit more polished, a little bit more evened out in my skin tone, but I don't feel the need to cover everything up necessarily. So that's definitely something that I would let you in on, is that if you want extra coverage, just rely on a concealer. Try the ILIA concealer. Maybe it's for you. I'm gonna say right now, it's definitely not my favorite. I've actually done a full review of a full face of ILIA products. I'll link that video up here and in the description down below, just so you can get a better idea of what a full face looks like, especially if you want that like light, easy breezy, simple makeup look. But the concealer is just not my favorite because I'm used to using small amounts of full coverage concealer. So like I just spot treat where I need it and get the coverage that I need. This is definitely more of like a medium level hydrating concealer, and it just moves a little bit too much under my eyes where I'm really prone to creasing and just doesn't give me the coverage that I need. It's great for spot treating on the face. So I will say that it works great with the foundations, but if you want something under your eyes and you deal with darkness, I can't speak for you, but I can speak for myself and say it was not my fave. I'm noticing now, even just with the light reflection from the window and the whiteness of my walls, you can see, I haven't even put any highlighter on or anything, that this is just the finish and the slight shine and dewiness that this gives you. I think it's really, really lovely, but again, something to be mindful of if you're prone to oil, especially as we get into the warmer months. It just might not feel the most comfortable if you don't use any sort of powder or something like that. And again, it works best with no skincare or like the least amount of skincare because it just has it built in and just needs kind of a drier canvas to grip to, in my experience. This I think you can treat like your regular foundation or like a lighter weight foundation, like a skin tint. I think it's really lovely. I think it's great and buildable. Again, not full coverage. You can still see some spots, but if that's what you're into, I recommend both. I love them. I think that's it. I think I covered all of my main points for you. I think they're both great. I think definitely certain people with different skin types may prefer one over the other. Again, if I were to be really simple and pare it down into different categories, this is for drier skin, this is for more oily skin, but there's definitely a lot of crossover and opportunity for people with all different kinds of skin types to enjoy both. I think the coverage is gonna be really light and refreshing, but just know that that's what you're getting yourself into and don't think that you're getting like full coverage. I really hope that helped. If you have any other questions, anything that I didn't cover, just drop me a comment below and I'm happy to address it. Like I said, I've spent months with both of these products, so I know pretty well in and out what I think works best for me and what could potentially work best for you. So just say hey, let me know what's on your mind and I will be happy to get back to you. Other than that, y'all, that's it for today. Thank you again for watching and for joining me. I hope you were able to get something out of this as you are on your shopping journey, especially if you're looking for these ILIA products and what maybe works best for you. If you're new here, please consider subscribing if you haven't already. It just helps me grow, and that's what I want to do. I just want to help you make better decisions Not like I'm questioning your decision making. I just know that I really help and I really appreciate when people have actual experience with something that I necessarily don't, or with the same thing, and I can find out, you know, what it's like for everybody. So I just picked my nose on camera. It was really more of like an outer, I just had an itch, guys. Seriously. As I was saying, please consider subscribing and like this video. Again, it just helps me grow. This is something that I hope to do full time and just build this community with you and really be able to have back and forth conversations and just provide any information that you might be needing, especially when it comes to all of your beauty purchases. So hang out for a little bit longer, check out other videos, check out the original ILIA video if you're looking for more of a demo and review of some of their other products. Generally speaking, I'm quite the fan, and you'll learn more when you watch. But that's it, everybody. I so appreciate you being here. Thank you for watching. But please, y'all, take care, be well, and I'll see you in the next video. Love you so much. Bye.